What's up, guys? Michael Kamala, medical student at the Mayo Clinic. Chances are, at some point in your life, you've been doing some cardio and have gotten a side ache. And a lot of you will have also felt some pain in your shoulder. Now, what exactly causes this pain? Currently, the most widely accepted theory is diaphragmatic ischemia leading to referred pain. Now, you've probably heard of referred pain before, but what exactly is it? Let's walk through the anatomy. What I have highlighted here is the diaphragm. It's a muscle that sits at the bottom of the lungs, and when it contracts, it creates a negative pressure in the chest cavity, which is what allows you to breathe in. Now, when you're doing a lot of cardio, this diaphragm is working really hard. If it's not used to working that hard, it becomes ischemic, aka has deficient blood flow, and that leads to inflammation. And inflammation transmits pain signals. Now I remove the right lung here so you can see the phrenic nerve, which I have highlighted. The phrenic nerve innervates the diaphragm, and as you can see, has branches that extend all the way to the side, and your brain interprets that as pain in your side. But why pain in the shoulder? Here I've isolated the pathway that the phrenic nerve travels to get up to the brain, and as you can see, it actually merges with several other branches, and those branches are coming from the arm and your shoulder. So because these nerve branches merge before they reach your brain, it has to decide where is this pain coming from. And if it's not used to your diaphragm working that hard, it'll decide that it's more likely the pain signals are coming from the branch in your arm, and that's when you get that shoulder pain. And that's the science behind it. Tag and share with your friends who need to do more cardio.